diaper review. Now, for the kids and teenagers that watch this, you know, well, and for adults too, for everyone out there, I have a disease that's called multiple sclerosis. Basically, it affects the nerves in my body. It makes it where my brain sometimes has a hard time communicating with my body parts, and I can't control everything, including some, I occasionally lose bladder control. And so I use catheters, which, you know, I mean, most people know what catheters are, I think. You know, I have used catheters. I try to cath at least once a day, just to try, but it's really hard because I have multiple sclerosis, so my fingers are really numb, and that, you know, from the waist down is even more numb than my fingers, because it's always like MS when I first started feeling it, I felt it in my butt. So anyway, it's hard to cath sometimes with numb fingers and numb everything, and then hard to even know, like, it's just hard, but, I try to do cathing at least once a day. I have thought about the possibility of getting one of those catheters, you know, I don't remember what they're called, but anyway, in the meantime, what I also do is, occasionally wear diapers, and, like, a lot of time wear diapers if I'm scared, because it's a whole lot better to have an accident in a diaper than it is to have an accident in your clothes. And so anyway, I wanted to review a couple. Now, my situation might be different than yours if you are out there and you also suffer from incontinence. Remember that diapers. I call them diapers. Most people call them, what's the official, that's the actual term, I don't know. But anyway, I'm calling them diapers. They're the adult protective underwear. But anyway, I'm a woman, so these are women's diapers. I also, have, like, my legs are pretty atrophied, and, you know, I've got a pretty small frame anyway, and so, bear that in mind, you know, depending on the body type, you might have very different reactions than what I have. Okay, so, the first one, okay, this, I actually like, and these, my sister sent them from, like, an online retailer, and they are Depends brand, but she found a size small. At the store, the Depends that I see, they're usually all a small medium, and one of these, no, I think it's this one, might be a Depends too, but I can't remember. I gotta look it up on my phone. But anyway, this it also, it seemed to go up, you know, high on the thigh area. Okay, so next we have this, which, that was, like, I think that one worked, but that was the always, let's see, always discreet boutique. And those, you know, they are supposed to be cute with a little bow. You know, I think they should do a different color, but maybe not. Like, maybe you do want kind of a skin tone flesh tone. These fit good. I don't know. Let me see if... Okay, so, like, another issue that you should think about when you're purchasing, you know, diapers is how well they're going to hold up. These ones that I've all showed you so far, they were, you know, they didn't rip when I pulled them up. It's pretty strong, you know, seams. But there was one, I think it was this one, that ripped a couple times when I was trying to get it on. And this is... Assurance. That's Women's Assurance. Yeah. And so I guess it's maybe the Walmart brand or something. But this, again, only came in small, medium. The leg openings were, you know, it was not as bad as the black one on the, like, cutouts for your legs, but I think this is the one that ripped, but I don't know, because now it's hard, because I've been, like, saving them. When I use up a pack, I'll be like, okay, and then I'll get a different type. Now this is always discreet underwear, small, medium size, but it fits really good, it's comfortable. I like it. Always good brand. Depends, seriously, like, stay tuned for their new sizes. I think that will be very helpful. Because that was also the black one. Depends brand. And again, that small medium was not very small medium. Okay, so, like, also, if you use diapers or something like that, you might want to think about having, like, a carrying a small scissors or a small, like, clipper or something in your bag to clip the sides, just in case. I mean, for me, sometimes with my fingers getting numb, it gets difficult, and I would rather the sides be stronger, not the kind that rips easily, because I had one, well, I think that was back when I was doing the kids, like, pull-up thing, that I had one that would rip. You know, I threw half of the pack away because they just ripped every time I tried to get it on. But anyway, okay, so that is my diaper review. It seems like I was supposed to talk about one other thing. I don't know, but you know what? Let's just say this. Okay, if you out there are struggling with incontinence, or experiencing it, it is a very difficult thing. And I used to, and still sometimes, do believe that it is, like, one of the worst parts of my disease. It's just so, so humiliating and stuff like that. But I think a lot of times I think of my bladder as a separate entity than me. Like, I'm me and then my bladder. You know, sometimes it can't. It's trying the best it can, too. I used to, you know, think it was my safe. You know, all this stuff. Don't you watch my videos? I said, like, I used to call it my sadistic master that would order me around and stuff. But now I think of it as daughter that has MS too, and so it's trying the best it can. But still, I don't take it as personally as I used to. Like, I used to, when I would have an accident or something, I would think, like, oh, you know, it sucks, and it would be so frustrating. But I think sometimes it's helpful to kind of recognize that's not you. Like, you aren't your body parts, whatever those body parts might be that's messing up. Like, your bladder, your bowels, your, I don't know, your spasms or whatever. I mean, you aren't your disease, you aren't your illness, and, you know, just try not to take it personally. And then a lot of times, you know, do what you can to make it easier on yourself. And for me, a lot of times that is using the adult diapers that are out there. And that might be an embarrassing thing. That might be, like, a lot of people are embarrassed to buy them or to talk about it or whatever. But it should be. It's just reality. Like, I have a disease that, you know, it affects me and my body parts. And so sometimes the best way to deal with it is to just protect your time, because that's really, ultimately, that's what incontinence is. It is a huge time waster, because, you know, you might be going to the store and all of a sudden you pee on yourself, and then it's like, no, there goes all your plans. So, anyway, don't let it get you down. Do what you can to just protect yourself and to, you know, don't beat yourself up if it happens to you, because, you know, it happens to a lot of people, not just drunk college kids.